Hey everybody, welcome to the April of 2022 Patreon Q&A. We're going to get straight into it and I'm going to butcher someone's name. Mark McCullough? I don't know, I'm sorry. We tried to work it out. Hi, Rinko? Rinsa?
Rinico?
Hope you are both well. I was wondering about your thoughts on E10 fuel in newer model 125cc bikes, or any bikes that are newer, to be honest. I have a Hoodlin 125cc 2021 model, and in the rare times I've had to use it, it struggles to start, then starts chugging as if it's running out of petrol. But as soon as I run some normal through, it just works fine. It works perfectly. Keep up the great work. Love your content. As I've mentioned a couple of times in recent videos, the reason why I use E5, which is the equivalent of our old standard petrol. Remember, super unleaded is gone. Now they've shunted things down, so now the best one is what we used to have as a standard. I have tried E10 in my bikes, and I have found the same problems. They don't like starting when they're cold. Well, not don't like starting, they will start, but they just seem to chug, and they just don't sound right, and the DR just doesn't feel right, and when I've put normal fuel in them, as in E5, they've just been perfect. The newer bikes should be able to deal with E10 no problem and not have any of these issues because of the fuel injection systems and stuff to make account for it, but it does seem like it's not really working as a replacement so well for many people. I think in cars it's not an issue, but then there is a mileage thing that's being brought up. So my thoughts are, if it works for you, great, and if it doesn't, enjoy paying like I do.
James the Naked Snake says, "Hey, Spree Cicino, if someone offered either of you, no strings attached, to get you through your car driving test for free and offered you a cheap runabout car/van that you could fit Spicy in, but you had to pay to maintain and insure it, would you accept that offer and you can't just take the cash value or sell the car?"
Yes. On one side, that's a pretty good deal.
Yeah.
On the other side, got nowhere to keep it.
Yeah.
Simple as that. So, Paul Pigger, "Hey Spicy and Reno, thanks for your kind words after my crash. Still just taking each day as it comes. Just started physio on my leg and as my kneecap was snapped in two places."
No.
She really has a thing about knees. "Several fractures in my leg plus my wrist with its plate 8 screws and 3 dislocated fingers. I name all my injuries because I was wearing all the right gear, so it shows how important it is to have good gloves, jacket, pants, boots, helmet. Otherwise, I would have been dead. So thank you for all the vids and knowledge, which helped save my life. Much love to Spicy and Reno." I think it's the gear that saved your life.
Yeah,
and you being smart enough to use it.
Yes.
But yeah, like me, I mean, in my crash, I had gloves, and I have permanent damage to my thumb. It doesn't move as much and stuff anymore.
But if you didn't have gloves, you might not have a thumb.
I likely wouldn't. It probably was the only thing that kept it on.
Oh.
But again, best of luck to you with your recovery. And exactly, one day at a time. I mean, my injuries weren't quite that bad, but I know it was a long process that you wish was shorter always.
Lee Bayliss says, "Hi, Ricey Sbrino."
These are getting you.
"One for Spicy." Well, this is Spicy's Q&A though, anyway, technically.
I don't know about this point. It's pretty much our Q&A.
Yeah, that's true.
Anyway,
"I saw an odd centipede / caterpillar looking thing, but it was hanging from the ceiling, almost looked like a spider. Any clue what it could have been?"
Any caterpillar. They hang down when they're turning into a moth or butterfly in many cases. So you'd need to get a picture of it or just see what comes out of it later. I'm afraid that's very normal. Mephisto, "Hey Spicy Reno." "Update on the shrimps." Okay, update on... Wait, which shrimps? Right, brine shrimps. They are not with us anymore. They haven't been for a long time.
They
did have babies.
Yeah.
But they just never grew to full adulthood. And it just slowly the numbers dwindled away until they were mostly gone. So, yeah, it was not great. As for the normal shrimps... I could do a bit of video at the end of this of the new tank, so we can show you.
I have two tanks now. And frog friends.
And those shrimps are okay.
Yeah.
That's all. Stay safe. So we'll answer that one and we'll show you at the end.
RoboNinja300 says, "Hey Spicy, hey Reno, hope you're both doing well."
Oh, there is more.
What's your thoughts on the XJ6 for touring and a runaround? Been looking at getting one as a second motorbike and wonder if it would be a good mid-range bike for riding and maybe doing a bit of touring, like maybe up to Scotland and to do the North Coast 500 on the NC500. And then just have it as a bike for distance riding, as my Ninja 300 sits high in the RPMs at 70 miles an hour, which I believe was a subject of one of your older videos, best mile per gallon, large CC versus small CC. Happy to say I'm not doing all those miles anymore thanks to relocating closer to home, and thank you and everyone who's commented on that video.
Yeah. Just thought I'd ask Spicy as your own one. Sorry for the long-winded question. In short, yes, it's a good long-range bike because it's quite comfortable at speed. However, I will say this, it does rev stick really high still. At 70, it's basically, at 70, you're doing about 7,000 RPM in sixth gear. Now, that isn't that many revs for that engine because it goes up to like 12 or whatever it is. But you are still, it hasn't got that low down dum 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 at 70. It's much more like. So long term might be a bit annoying. Adjust the gearing for that. I'm sure it could deal with that. But remember, it's only got 78 brake horsepower, so it might be. And it has got more torque than like the R6. I don't know if it had more torque than the R6, but it was made to be a more torquey engine. So with a sprocket change, yeah, I think it could be good for that. The only thing with it is comfort, whether it fits you or not. But then Reno can flat foot it.
Can't yes, you?
And
I can,
I
actually
am comfy on it. And it's a weird bike for that tall and short riders seem to fit.
Yeah.
I hope that helps. Anthony Butterworth. Hi, Reno and Spicy. Which do you prefer, chicken pie or beef pie? Chicken pie.
Both. I only like chicken pie if it's not chicken and mushroom pie. If you put the mushrooms in, for me, it ruins it, and then you just taste mushroom and it's bad. So chicken pie on its own, yes. Or beef pie as it is, yes.
I think she has stronger feelings about pie than I do.
David R. says, hi, Sprino. Hope you're both doing well. I just wondered whether bikes that have been decatted with full systems are legal and would pass an MOT.
At this point in time, removing a catalytic converter from your bike is fine, as is removing the indicators, the lights and things like that, if to get it through a daylight MOT, the mirrors, all of these things. I decatted my XJ6 when I got the Black Widow exhaust. That was not necessarily through choice. It's just the fact that the system is one piece with the cat in the middle of it. However, there is talk now at the moment about the anti-tampering rules and stuff in courts to do with things that may lead to them trying to stop people removing catalytic converters from bikes. However, the knock-on effects of that with other things is a bit of an issue, and it is being debated at the moment. I did see a video the other day with a gentleman who was talking about his three motorcycles. He had a KTM like 950 Supermoto or something. The case he put across was absolutely fantastic. But I can see why they want to do that. But at the moment, no, it's completely legal, but it may not be in the future. And they have clarified by saying it won't be retrospective. So if you've done, so like my XJ6, if I've removed the cat, then it's okay. I assume they're going to track modifications retrospectively by starting to track them. Because if you don't know, otherwise you could just go there and go, oh, it was like that years ago. Like, okay.
Well, they could probably, would they be able to tell from the MOTs?
Well, no, because they would just say whether the exhaust is compliant or not. If they said, they might have a new box that says stock, non-stock or something like that. So if it said stock and then the following year you go back in the future and it's non-stock and it's still, and it's not got the cat, they'll go, well, last time, blah, blah, blah. It's kind of up in the air at the moment, and I haven't talked about it yet, even though I know a lot of people always want me to talk about the most current subject. I don't like to do anything too soon because it's going to just be my opinion, which is based in nothing. I like to wait till more facts appear and then I can read between the lines and see what I think. At the moment, they might just throw it out. Who knows?
And that's the other thing. If you do it too soon, it could change and then be completely different.
This is what did that happen with? When they were banning electric cars, when they brought the electric car ban in, first bikes were included, or they weren't included, then they were included, then they weren't. So I made a video and people said, no, that's wrong. And then I made a video to correct it. And then by that point, people said, no, that's wrong, because it had been switched again. Then I made another video and now I'm on track with it, which is motorbikes are banned. All internal combustion engines are banned to be sold for road use, to my understanding. including motorcycles, from 2030, whatever it is. So, yeah.
Julian L says, hi, Spino. Simple question this time. What's the secret to a happy life?
Loach.
Yes. The loach.
No one will
get yourself that. A coolie loach. Okay. They start off very small. They start off like little whammies. And by the time they have grown, you will not realize how small they were when you first got them until you see a whole group of them all together like this, all stacked on together. And then you're like, whoa, they are very small. They are very cute. And they have little mustaches. Loach.
My actual answer was being weird and being okay with it. Which we both are. You have no idea.
Well, I guess that just showed, didn't it?
Yeah, that was my point. I just had to say loach and there we go.
Oh, there's more questions.
Yeah, there's one more.
Oh. You read or I read?
Well, you read the last one. So, oh, it's my one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, so the last question. I have actually got my phone out for this because they asked this in between me printing those earlier. And like, I printed them, walked back in the room, my phone went ping, and I was like, oh, really? I remembered to look it up. Hey, Spicy and Reno and Spicy. Hope you're both well. Once all the vast majority of vehicles on the road are electric, one, will they be MOT or PAT tested? That's funnier than it should be. They will be MOT'd. Maybe both. Two, when repairs are needed, will they be taken to a mechanic or an electrician? This is actually quite interesting. So my video I did recently talking about robots, like the inevitable future, I realised there is a variety of subjects where I feel like I could speculate with the information we have now and talk about what I think is the inevitability of the future. Call it my predictions for the future. That's all it's going to be. It's not going to be a serious thing. But that was the first instalment. And one of the videos I want to do is talk about the future of electric vehicles and what implications and changes that might bring to the world. I'm not going to get into the huge argument about how they work and whether lithium this or blah blah blah. The fact is, we're going to be going down the petrol route, so the non-petrol route. So there are options. I mean, it's like I had a discussion with someone this morning who, it was a very interesting their point of view, but they sort of said about how that in maybe in, you know, 50 years time we'll see that we're still using lithium cars, or all the lithium fell through, it's just a fad. And I don't understand that train of thought, because lithium-ion batteries were invented in the mid-80s. It's only now the 2020s. Why would we not, like, you know, develop any more battery technology, as if anything could replace it and be better, as if the thing made when I was born, the year I was born, was the best thing that ever came out, and they're never going to get it better. You've got to be more open-minded and realise that problems are solved. Anyway, we need to end this one. Huge thanks to my Patreon supporters that have remained. Noticed quite a significant loss this month. You know, that might be down to cost of living. It might be down to people's cards expiry dates coming up, because the month that it is, I think April, May is like quite a common date for it. But yeah, I do understand the cost of living is going up, but it hasn't gone down for me, so losing patrons really hurts. Thank you to the support of everyone, as always, and I will catch you in the next one.
Stay tuned for Loach and Shrimp Sandwiches.
Oh, yes, we need to do this. Yes, sorry about that. We will now go and see the loach.
Okay, so the original tank with all of the guppies and the shrimpies, and I'm having to manual focus here because this camera is not liking this. Where are the shrimps and shrimpies? Oh, Miss Dog Orami.
No, he's still a feist. Friendly feist.
Miss Dog Orami.
Miss Dog Orami, you going to bite?
Yes.
Orami.
The new tank, however, has got, what's it got in it? Froggies?
Yes.
Where are the frogs? Oh, frog.
There's one there. Oh, a little frog. One of them is very fat. One of them is a chonk.
These are African dwarf frogs?
Yes.
They're a bit stupid.
Don't be mean to them. They're just a bit slow. They're a bit delayed.
Tetras.
A million snails.
There's also wood shrimp in here, but I haven't. Oh, I've got a video on my phone. Show them. They're and like the corridors.
Oh, the little mustaches.
Little mustache meeting. This is probably weird. And the pretty little gobies. So there you go. Tank update.